Welcome back, guys, to another episode of Red Dead Redemption. Okay, so we just awoke from a nice slumber there. Still kind of recovering from our bullet wound, but I think we're going to be okay. And it looks like we have a new objective here on the map. The B for Bonnie. Bonnie McFarland. Alright, we don't want to shoot that guy. Almost decided to shoot him. Does she have a place to hitch our horse? Maybe not. Right, we'll just walk inside. Obstacles in our path! Alright, see what we got going on here.
Oh, Mr. Marston. How are you doing today?
I'm well, Miss McFarland. Thank you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Thank you. So, how are your ribs?
Fine. A little sore, but apart from a couple extra scars, it'll be as nothing happened.
Good. Come in. You know, you never did tell me how you met that Bill Williamson or what you wanted from him.
No, miss, I did not.
Well, why not, if you don't mind me asking?
I certainly don't mind you asking if you don't mind me not telling.
Ha!
See, it's a complicated and somewhat pathetic tale, and by telling you, not only would I be putting your life in danger, but also threatening the lives of some people that I hold very dear.
Well, I apologize if I seem to be prying.
And I apologize for my reticence. Hope you believe me when I say that it's simply out of respect for you.
Of course, Mr. Marston. I understand that a city dweller such as yourself likes to have some exotic secrets so us country folk are impressed.
I'm no city man, miss.
Yeah, but I saw you get on the train at Blackwater. You with those gentlemen in bowler hats?
I'm still no city man.
But I'll bet you can't ride, Mr. Marston.
I hate to take money from a lady, miss.
Oh, you won't be. I'll race you right now.
If it makes you happy.
We'll see.
She's seriously challenging us to a race right now. All right, let's get it, boys. Horse racing. We love racing in GTA and pretty much every other game on the planet. We're going to see what we can do here in Red Dead Redemption on a horse.
Come on, boy.
Come on.
Oh, the race start. I'll race you to the start. Ha!
On the count of three. Three, two, one.
It's on, baby. Here we go. All right.
You're not gonna be a gentleman about this.
You don't know me at all, Miss McFarland.
Gotta hit all these checkpoints. Raypoints are marked by plumes of smoke. It's shown as the dots on the map. All right, this is tough, guys. So what we have to do is we get a speed boost by tapping A, like we are right now. But it also makes your horse run out of stamina. So you have to do a mix of tapping A and holding. What was that, a coyote?
Go!
You have to do a mix of tapping A and holding A. Because if you tap too much, your horse will buck you off. Oh, we've got deer out here? So if you stay on the roads, you go faster too. Horse trails.
Come on.
Oh my gosh, man.
Come!
She's right on our tail. I don't like this. A decent lead here, but
come on.
This is actually kind of hard. You have to keep it to this tiny little horse trail if you want max speed. It's constantly moving. It's hard to see. Like, I'm mainly working off of my mini map. It's hard to see the horse trail by itself. Oh, she's coming up on us. Where are we going? Oh, shoot. There it is. Go right. Holy cow, dude. That section was tough. Where are you at, Ms. McFarland? How's the weather back there?
Come on.
My finger's slipping on the thumbstick, dude. All right, we're killing her now. We are way ahead right now. Woo! Coming back into town.
Come on.
Girl, you call this a race? I call this a trot. There's the finish line. Let me just take a bow really quick.
That was fun.
Sure.
You know, you should go pay the marshal a visit in Armadillo sometime. I'm sure he could help you deal with that nice Mr. Williamson.
Yeah, I might just do that, Miss McFarlane.
You do whatever you think's best, Mr. Marston.
We're still so formal. Like, hey, yo, what up, Bonnie? What up, girl? All right. Marshall Johnson's available to talk to you in Armadillo. Travel to M on your map, or we also have another mission here with Bonnie. I'm going to say let's do Bonnie since we're so close. It's like GTA, though. It's open world, so you can go around and choose what missions you want to do.
Oh, Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good, Miss McFarlane. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies, and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman.
All right.
Take the reins, Mr. Marston.
We can do that. Get up on the other side. Approach the driver's seat and press Y.
You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's a relief. Perhaps there's hope for you yet.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, there's always hope, Mr. Marston. You can't be a rancher in this kind of country if you don't believe that.
An admirable attitude, miss.
I suppose so. I can't think of any other way to stay sane, to be frank. What about you? Have you ever given up hope altogether?
Hope hasn't really entered into it. It's not really something I think about.
A peculiar outlook. I can't really say I understand you.
I can't always say I do either.
Oh, don't be so deliberately enigmatic.
I'm not, miss.
Yes, you are. You are being deliberately obscure as a substitute for having a personality.
I just know there are two theories to arguing with women, and neither one works.
I'm not even going to dignify that gibberish with a response.
Doesn't seem to be a method to the madness when it comes to traffic. Everybody's just kind of doing their own thing. Big Armadillo way down there.
You dying on the side of the road, and now you're driving me into town.
You have a strange sense of humor.
Well, you must admit, it's an unusual start to a friendship.
I didn't realize we were friends, Miss McFarlane.
Just got friend-zoned.
Now who's being funny? Listen, I know that business with Williamson is your business, but I don't know. You've been good to us, and I don't think you're a bad man. A little stupid, perhaps, but not rotten. I just worry about you gallivanting around these parts like you're some kind of deranged bounty hunter. Like Paul always says, don't go waking snakes.
I appreciate your concern for us lesser mortals, Miss McFarlane. I really do. And if there was any other way out, I'd take it. I can assure you of that.
All right, we made it into town. Hold RB to slow down. We made it.
So this is Armadillo. Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. First one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done.
All right, it's time to go get medicated, boys. Make sure we're healing up right. Don't want any problems.
The whole
talk to the doctor and purchase some medicine.
How are you, friend?
I'm selling some good tonics if you need them.
All right, he's got medicine, chewing tobacco, and apples.
I hope that helps.
Chewing tobacco is $35? Are you kidding me?
Thank you kindly.
You could have more than you have two bulletsectomies when they take out bullets. You still couldn't afford some chewing tobacco. That's crazy.
Well, thanks for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once, and a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
Tip of the hat to you, miss. All right, she's heading back, and now we find ourselves in Armadillo, our next... Oh, God! What did she just do to that guy? If you want to leave Armadillo, there are usually stagecoaches loading and unloading right behind the freight station. It's probably going to cost money, though. All right, so we could go talk to the,
Hello.
The sheriff, right? What do they call him? Not even sure what he's called, but he's the M on our map over here. Sheriff. Political realities in Armadillo. Some top-notch
Excuse me.
Security there.
Hey, you got a visitor.
Door's wide open.
Shut up, you. Now, what you want?
My name's John Marston. You wanted to speak to me.
I did?
Apparently so.
Why?
I guess because we're both in the business of the law.
You that fella from the train company?
No, I'm from Fort Mercer.
Fort Mercer? You them, one of them Williamson boys.
Calm down.
Go on, shoot him, mister. Shoot him.
Come what? You getting cute with me, boy?
What's going on here?
I got me one of them Williamson boys.
I got me one of them idiots who give marshals a bad name.
Jonah, put your gun down.
Okay, so this is the sheriff.
You must be the man from Blackwater.
Yes, sir. Listen, that dog ain't too bright. But he seems loyal.
Jonah, get out of here for a minute.
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson, sir. And you. Oh, I done seen enough of your hide around here, friend.
I think there's some school children down the way you can go and frighten.
Oh, hardy fucking whore, dickhead.
What are you doing here, Mr. Marston? Apart from frightening my deputies.
I'm here to capture or kill Bill Williamson.
Okay.
Can you help me?
He's outside my jurisdiction. He's in the next county. Of course, Bill Williamson and his boys have tended to keep themselves away from my town.
So you're happy to have him out there?
Well, I ain't happy, but I also ain't suicidal. My job is to keep this town safe, not clean up all of these three counties. It's hard enough around here.
You know, I hear you speak, and suddenly I'm reminded of how some of the people I respected most in my life had a problem with authority. What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm sure you and your fine friends have enjoyed spending your time running around pursuing noble causes. My cause is to keep this town from turning into a living hell for the folks who live here. Whole world has problems, mister, and I'm here doing what I can.
Why? What's happening?
Right now? I got the railway, the people who pay my salary, trying to get me to turn a blind eye to them burning down settlements up there. I got a bunch of cattle rustlers out near Box Canyon needs shutting down. Not forgetting the gang that keeps murdering homesteaders out in the backcountry. And I got a bunch of hoods over in the saloon, drunk, threatening to shoot up the whole town. That's all I got today. But it's early yet. Give me a couple more days. There'll be more.
All right. Tell you what. Let's go deal with them hoods in the saloon. Then we'll discuss Williamson.
Okay, boy. You're a persistent little cuss, ain't you?
Only when things matter.
All right. It's time to go handle business. We got some boys making a ruckus in the saloon. Getting drunk and causing problems, so, we're gonna go let them know what's up.
So who are we looking for?
A bunch of two-bit hoodlums, led by this fella called Walton. Goddamn road agents who prey on the stages coming in and out of town. Drivers and armadillos spend more time with their hands in the air than on the reins these days.
And you're happy to let them drink in your saloon?
Happy?
No.
But the way I figure it, better they're carousing in there than out robbing decent folk.
That's an interesting approach to law enforcement.
Where's the dumb rat bastard now? Let's follow him. See what kind of hole he crawls into.
All right. Press up to whistle for your horse and it will come.
Let's get after him. Damn, he's seen us. Come on.
Ha.
Uh-oh. Has he already seen us? Here comes my horse. Hold up, horsey. All right, we're good. Come Tell on. Walton to his hideout with Marshall Johnson. Do not kill Walton. Okay, that's a...
If Walton's as bad as you say he is, why don't we just beef him now while we got the chance?
Because that ain't how the law works.
Kind of unfortunate.
Right, Marshall.
And alive, he can still talk.
Doesn't sound like he's the man to be reasoned with.
He ain't. But a few days of my hospitality and he'll be telling me what I need to know. Walton's gang's been growing fast.
Outlawing's easy money for easy work.
Chola Springs, Gap Tooth Ridge, these boys get around. Walton's a start, but there's plenty more where he came from.
Right.
He's headed for Pleasant's house. Let's stop so we can get a better look.
Whoa there.
Sneaking around with the sheriff. This is kind of cool.
Looks like we got company, boys.
All right, it's time to start popping shots then. Let's go.
We'll work our way up this hill.
Over here, pussy.
Arson, I got you covered. Move up to that wagon.
Woo! Got him. I can do that. It's RB for cover, right? So you auto-aim to their chest, but if you want a headshot, you've got to aim up. Got him. Got him. I don't even know if headshots are necessary, but... He's down. Woo! Try to take him alive. All right, how do you want me to do that? Just walk up to the front door? Whoa.
Nice shooting, boy. I'd have preferred him to swing, but I guess beggars can't be choosers. At least we got the son of a bitch.
Well, sorry I failed you, sir. I didn't want to shoot him, but he shot me first.
Why don't you check in with me next time you're in town?
I don't want to be no policeman, Marshal.
Nor did I, my friend. I can promise you that. I'll see you soon, Mr. Marston.
All right, we just killed like seven dudes. Marshall's just gonna drive right off, and that's that. That's all she wrote. Nothing to worry about. We're just gonna move on. Can we pick up some, we got $20? We have $20 to our name now. It's like being an outlaw could be a little bit more rewarding than we thought. Might wanna consider a career change. Oh, okay, I thought we just got decide. Okay, but yeah, basically there's a good and a bad. You guys remember like Infamous and stuff like that, some of those old series? If you do good things, you get honor. you do bad things, you get dishonor, and you can become a good or a bad guy, and then people react to you differently based off of that, which is kind of cool. But let's see what we've got going on next. We're going to go ahead and pull up our map. And looks like back there with Marshall Johnson is going to be our next closest objective. So we're going to head back that way, and we'll see you guys in our next episode.